Chairman, first of all, I'd like to request unanimous approval to submit to the record a statement by the Governor of Virginia, a statement by the City of Suffolk, Virginia, and also questions that we have requested that be asked by the Department.
Without objection.
Mr. Chairman, also have enormous respect for you, and one of the things that frightens me about Secretary Lynn's testimony today is he specifically says he doesn't believe there's any risk of reverting back to the pre-Goldwater-Nicholas Act of jointness. I think there's a huge risk. Might not be concerned about all of the cost to the Commonwealth of Virginia. I don't expect members here to be concerned, but we should be concerned about this. Number one news story on the day this was announced in the Communist Chinese press was the closure of the Joint Forces Command and how it was going to help them, because their number one weakness when they're working with the Russians has always been jointness. Secondly, it's coming to a theater near you. If they can do this process here and not have any kind of openness and not include anybody, they'll do it anywhere across the country. The third thing is, we've just sent a message out to all of our partners across America. You better be careful when you deal with the Department of Defense, because don't count on them being open and having a process. If they just decide they're going to close something, they'll make that decision and get the analysis later. And I want to go back to what I was talking about, Mr. Secretary, with this cloud of lack of transparency that you guys have pulled down the drapes in the Pentagon. Last year, and I understand why, because we haven't really, as a committee, held you accountable to that. Last year, you issued a gag order that prohibited any of the individuals at the Department of Defense from even talking to members of Congress about the ramifications of some of your cuts. We had hearings that were canceled because people couldn't come here and testify. And what did we do about it? This committee did nothing. When you refused by the requirement you have by law to give us a shipbuilding plan so we'd know what you were doing with building ships, and we asked you in every way we could, and you just refused to do it, what do we do about it? We didn't do anything. When you were required by law to give us an aviation plan, and you just refused to do it, and we asked you and asked you and asked you, and you just failed, we didn't do anything about it. You've had 11 years of testimony, analysis supporting Joint Forces Command. You make 90 days of backroom meetings, and you come in here and give us conclusions but no analysis. What are we going to do about that? Not a scintilla of evidence. You wouldn't respond to members of Congress, both the Senate and this, Republicans and Democrats. My friend Congressman Scott has been right with us on asking this. He's had the same kind of problems that we've had. The Governor of Virginia, you met with him yesterday. You went 7 weeks. Wouldn't he return his telephone calls to just sit down and say, what are you doing and how are you doing it? Yesterday at the so-called meeting that you had with us, you wouldn't let the press come in. We asked you to let the press come in. You took our telephones away, any recording devices, and there wasn't any classified information or anything that had executive privileges, but you just don't want the public to know some of this information. You've issued a gag order to the personnel in Joint Forces Command, refusing to let them talk if they have a counter opinion to yours. And one of the questions I'd have for you today is, will you give us a copy? Will you give the chairman, the ranking member, a copy of that order that you made them sign, that non-disclosure agreement today? You know, at some point in time, Mr. Chairman, enough is enough. We need the analysis and we need the facts. I think this is the time. And Mr. Chairman and Mr. Ranking Member, we so respect both of you, but today we'll be sending you a letter that's going to be signed by Democrats and Republicans, and not just people from Virginia, requesting that we have backed up, we've drawn a line in the sand, we've said, please give us this information, you've refused. We've backed up again and drawn a line in the sand, and you've just refused. We've backed up again and drawn a line in the sand, and you refused. And Mr. Chairman, Mr. Ranking Member, we're going to request that if they keep pushing us against this wall, that this committee issue a subpoena to them requiring this information be given to us, because I think it's right for the American people. And Mr. Lynn, I'll just close by saying this. You may work for the President, you might work for the Secretary of Defense, but you do work for the American people. They're the ones that pay your bills, they're the ones that send their sons and daughters to fight our wars, and they have a right to know this information. And we ought to be able to give them this analysis and put it on the table, because as the Chairman said, we can't afford to go back, and we need, as part of a Congress, not to have to come with our hat in our hand pleading for you to give us crumbs of information. We ought to be able to come to you and you give us the analysis and the information so that we can do the due diligence we have to have an oversight function to protect the greatest military the world has ever known. And with that, Mr. Chairman, I yield back the balance of my time.
Thank you, gentlemen.